Okay, what's going on YouTube? This is Big Juan Robles, aka Stan Nelson with Top Deck Gaming. To my left, my brother.
Zeno. How you doing?
He sucks at this. Anyway, so for this video, guys, me and my brother here, we wanted to kind of talk about an upcoming tournament that's going to be happening in Modesto on the 28th?
Yes.
28th. And it's going to be the fourth tournament that we have kind of been a part of. Since our good friend Brandon Gregory has put it together. So we're going to be talking about that, what's coming up for that tournament, kind of like our thoughts about it, how we feel about it going into it. We're also going to talk about some deck ideas, some new deck ideas that I've come up with or my brother's come up with, along with a bunch of other things. Sorry. Anyways, we're also going to talk about some cards on the ban list that... either me or my brother kind of feel that we just don't agree with, or why we think they need to be at least given a little bit of love, put them back at 2, or to limit some other ones, and just talk about cards overall. So without further ado, let's get right into it, and we'll start it off with the tournament coming up. What are your thoughts?
Well, I'm excited. I've only been to the first one, couldn't make the last two. The first one I did okay, I did terrible, but... I had a lot of fun, a lot of jitters going in because, I mean, hadn't been in a tournament in, what, 6 years?
long time.
Been a long time. So it's a lot of fun. I'm glad we're still doing it. Everyone else seems to have a big deal, and I believe it's growing slowly but surely for Central Valley players. A little bit closer to home this time, too, which is nice. Hopefully be able to stay a little bit longer and won't have to leave immediately after, so... that's nice, but, you know, tooling the decks, been hyping myself up a little bit in the last week or two.
That's bugging me. When are you going to be home? When are you going to be home? I got deck ideas, man. So, yeah, definitely hyped.
Yeah, but I'm pretty happy with the build I got for the deck I'm going to take, and, yeah.
What are you playing, by the way, when you go? You gonna kind of like keep it under hush hush, or are you gonna let people know what's going on?
No, I'm gonna keep it hush hush because if everyone is still playing the deck, I think they're playing, which is True Allies, which won the first tournament. I think it's a pretty good counter to that. So I'm hoping if I don't win, I'm gonna piss some people off. And yeah, that's always fun.
I've already play tested you today, and it was not fun. It was horrible. But, so yeah, you know, like Zeno said, the game has been growing more so, it feels, in the last year or two, as opposed to when the game really did die out, at least for me anyways. I really didn't start getting back into this until a couple of years ago, but to see all the people who are interested and all the people who want to be a part of the community, it's awesome, because... it's hard to find people that share that same common interest with you, and you know, is more than so is sharing that passion that you have for the game. So it's cool to be around people like that, and it makes obtaining cards way easier because Troll and Toad's constantly sold out or overpriced. Stop to Shop, it's another one that just doesn't do it for me, and you'll tend to find better deals and prices from players. Just because they understand, you know, they go through the same thing.
Yeah.
So
it's growing on top of that too, because New York's doing a tournament soon.
That's true. What's his name? Anthony? I think his name's Anthony. He's on the Facebook page, the Naruto CCG Facebook page,
which we should probably link on.
Yeah, and we know
the description.
We'll add a link definitely. And he's been putting together what sounds like it'd be a big tournament down in New York. So that would be cool for all those East Coast players. I wish I could make that, but, you know, New York, Fresno, we're miles. It's almost like two worlds, so... But so, big shout-out to him for putting that together and his crew out there. But, yeah, Naruto's definitely still something that people are a part of. And, you know, to any of you who are subscribed to the channel, who have told your friends about the channel, and you're trying to get them into Naruto, definitely push it, just because it's a fun, easy game to learn. I've had countless hours of enjoyment from it, and again, it's one of those things that definitely brings people together, and that's what it's all about, especially in a time now where there's so much hatred. One thing that could bring people together, sit down, play some cards, have a good time, try not to rage quit, you know, but it happens, right?
Yeah.
So, with that said, we'll go into some recent deck ideas that has come up over the past couple of weeks. I think to start off, one of our main players that we play with, our buddy Fade, he's really coming to his own as a player. He plays a very strange Taijutsu deck. I think in one of the earlier videos he did a video on it and like a deck profile. It didn't come out exactly the way we were hoping, but since then he's become a more confident player. So we'll probably put another video of him profiling his deck again, so you guys can take a look at it, get some ideas. Okay, yeah. Yeah, see how his brain works, because trust me, it's way off from anybody else I know.
But, which is one of those things that I think he's learning, because, you know, he played with us at the very beginning when it all started, you know, back in, you know, 2005 or whatever, or probably before that, but yeah. Anyways. But, you know, since you guys discovered it, brought me in, you know, I mean, he's played all that time, but he was never, you know, he was always like, you know, my favorite's Rock Lee, my guy, and, you know, I really want to, you know, keep that sort of thing going on. And we've never strayed from it too much, but now that, you know, the game's dead, we have access to all of the different cards from all the different sets, you know, now he's finally able to find those cards that he wants, and that's good for him. And like you said, definitely a stronger player.
Yeah, much overall, stronger.
Doesn't take it 3 hours to play a game anymore. So that's always nice.
Yeah. Enough about him, though. these recent deck ideas, that's not really my forte. I kind of like to stick to what I know, and that's Earth and Wind. This is the deck idea guy. So what do you talk about when you said recent deck ideas?
Oh, well, you know me. I love to make random decks. You know, if I see some sort of combination or some sort of,
this. Yes,
yes,
I know.
This. theme. That's the word I'm looking for. Some sort of theme or something. I like to put it together just to see how it'll work.
AKA your vanilla deck.
Yes, my vanilla deck. That's always a fun deck. I've recently retooled that a little bit too. That was the deck that if I wanted to go, that would be the one I would take. Because I know it's not the best deck in the world, but I would have a lot of fun with it.
And that's what this game is about. It's about having fun.
Yeah.
So, if anybody here is trying to tell you you're a bad player just because you like to try something different and be new, don't listen to them. They're just being assholes. Trust me. I tell him this all the time. So, don't be discouraged when somebody says, oh, your deck is bad. Or, why would you put that in your deck? Your deck is what you make it, and it's, in a lot of ways, a direct reflection of who you are as a person. So don't let anybody take that away from you, because that is 90% of the game. It's just having fun.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you can take, you know, one of our deck profiles, make the exact same deck, but, you know, everyone's got a different play style. Everyone likes more chakra, more hand, you know, different conservative ninjas.
Hanabi.
So, I mean, you know, some of those cards just won't work for you. And so, I mean, if you get a deck idea from something online or from one of us or a friend or something, you know, just go with the basic idea and kind of make it your own. Not everyone's going to put the same thing in. So, recently, though, I mean, I have decks from everything. I have a star deck.
Yes, star. Or the cancer deck.
The cancer deck.
Cancer deck.
Cancer deck. We want to make the Kimimaro deck at some point, which is the AIDS deck.
yes.
But recently I made a quartet deck, which is some guys... I forgot what set they were from, but...
Yeah, I'm not really sure the set, but if you don't know who the Quartet Ninjas were, it's a Naruto movie that they came out with, and it's basically the ninjas that had like those weird slug things that like went into the back of their neck and gave them this incredible power. Those are those guys. It's probably not the best description, but if you know Naruto, then you know what I'm talking about. But so,
but I put that together, and I actually gave it some thought when I was doing it, and it came out a lot better than I expected.
Yeah, it did.
It plays a lot better than I expected, because they all have, you know, effects that synergize with each other, and you can get pretty insane team powers off a team that's no more than probably 11.
Mm-hmm.
But you can boost that up to, what, 19 pretty easily? 20,
yeah, something like that.
Easily. So that was a lot of fun, putting a deck together like that. Because, I mean, Star hasn't been working out very well.
Yeah, it's hard when your main ninjas are killing themselves. But anyways, I think the closest deck that I've kind of put together in the recent weeks was it's a Datara deck. Not that great. At least not how I built it anyways. And Datara is probably one of my favorite Akatsuki ninjas, and that's half the reason why I made it. The other half is because he's been pushing me to make it for...
Well, I just want to see what
you
like.
Yeah, he's been pushing it to be made for like 3 or 4 years now. And so I just said, finally, you know, forget it. I'll put it together. Didn't have half the cards I actually needed for it. So thank you, Jason Smith, for the two Super Dateras and his Jutsu. Appreciate that. Those came in super fast. Also, just do a quick shout out. If any of you guys are looking for anything associated with this game, hit up Jason Smith, okay? This guy has everything you could ever want, and he deals very well, and you get your stuff fast. He's been great to work with, so I just want to give him that shout-out. Thank you, sir. But besides that, it's really not that great. Obviously, it has some room to build.
Yeah.
But until then, that's really the only thing that I've made. Besides that, I play puppets and I play BR Flip, and that's my thing, and people hate me for it because cheap cards make cheap decks, I guess, but whatever.
Conqueror Black Hand.
Yeah, Conqueror Black Hand, Poison Coins, GG for the win. But yeah, so anything else on the deck list?
No, I think that's all the recent stuff I have.
Yeah.
I haven't thought of too much lately.
That's it, yeah, for sure. So with all that, we went over the tournament, we went over recent deck ideas. Kind of give a couple shout outs there. So, what we really want to talk about is the ban list that we use. Again, we can link a description below what the ban list is that we are currently using.
Which is the Italian, I believe.
Yeah, the Italian ban list.
Yeah. Now, that hasn't been updated since the game died out in tournament style.
Right. But it's the base one that we use. And recently, since we've used it, we have added heart to heart communication. We've added Moroku and, I believe, Anko's Memory.
Yes, is banned.
All three of those were put to zero for good reason, I think. If you don't know, Heart-to-Heart Communication says negate all effects, correct?
I don't remember what Heart-to-Heart.
You know what? I think I have it right here, actually.
Here it is, right there.
Heart-to-Heart Communication. It's a permanent. It's one turn cost, one hand cost, Lightning or Earth. And it says... Players cannot search for any cards in their decks or put them in play, each card except by deploying them. So that takes out platooning. It takes out squatting.
No, it takes out platooning too.
Oh yeah, platooning, squatting, reinforcements,
growth.
Yeah. So it basically limits you to only playing one ninja card at a time. And in case you were wondering, that really affects the flow of the game for you personally because there's so many combos built off of playing. One ninja growthing a ninja that's already on the field and then squatting them out and then or whatever you have to do to give you that competitive edge, it really puts a stop to that. So that's a great card to put at zero, especially if it comes in on turn one.
Yeah, that'll hurt you for the rest of the team.
Yeah, it's
cool. I mean, it's not like I like to run playful Eno, which one ninja per turn both players though. Like it limits both of you.
Yeah.
So, sometimes I have to catch myself, and man, it's a bit of a double-edged sword, but, it has a drawback to it. Something like Moroku, which does the same thing, ninjas can only be deployed, they can't be put play any other way.
Yeah.
So, I mean, yeah, those cards are tough. There are a few other cards like that, but, something like heart-to-heart communication where you can't search either.
Yeah, that's a tough one, absolutely. Especially like True Allies.
Yeah.
You search for everything if there's
a very popular deck. And you search for everything. Heart-to-heart communication is a really good card, but having both those effects where you can't search and can only deploy,
It's tough.
That's a tough one.
It's tough. The last one that we had mentioned was Anko's Memory. That one's an iffy one for me because its effect only lets you bring three cards from your chakra back to your hand. Yeah, it's a good card, absolutely. And for certain deck styles, I can see why it would be OP. But even when it was at one, while we were playing in our tournaments before we banned it, I only ever saw it used once. And I just don't feel like it's a card that really...
Yeah.
Like, necessarily, like, prevents you, or prevents your opponent from, like, getting an edge or giving you an edge, especially. Yeah.
Especially because everyone played Lightning, no one really played Water.
Yeah.
And I feel like that card, as good as it is in Lightning, because, you know, you build Chakra like crazy in Lightning, but you're also getting back Jutsus that draw, or, you know, Jutsus or missions that draw, or missions that search, or stuff like that. So even with it is one, and then at the same time, you got other cards for decks like True Allies, Kakashi, and you know, things like that, and you're going to bring that card back constantly.
Yeah.
So even if you only use it once, or even if you don't use it and just happen to get discarded, you're going to bring that card back somehow. So I feel like that was kind of the issue.
Yeah, okay. You know? There you go. That's why we have two minds here. Different perspectives. So Uncle's Memory, you know, obviously it's a 50-50 thing for me and him, but I mean, definitely a good card, but everybody has their opinions.
Yeah.
So after that, there are cards we want to talk about that we feel need to be on the ban list or need to be given some love from the ban list.
Yeah.
One of our personal favorites is now bear with me, it's a lot. Tsuchigomo style Forbidden Jutsu release Big Bang. It's a set 21 card, Shattered Truth. And this card, it's a jutsu card, and it says you pay one chakra, I believe it's lightning or wind.
Lightning or wind,
and the effect says charge one card from your hand
and draw
two cards. Oh, in that case. Draw two cards.
Yeah.
This card, it's at one. The card's at one. It's a very early aggro card.
Yeah.
Absolutely. There's no downside to this card. It's, you get a chakra. Well, you're kind of replacing one.
Yeah, you're replacing chakra.
You replace the one chakra you used to spend, so you're really you're not going negative.
Yeah.
That jutsu is going to your chakra area after it's been applied, so you're actually gaining one more. And then, on top of that, draw two cards. So, you know, early game, you want to chump block or do whatever, you're giving yourself a bigger hand, you're giving yourself a more threatening field because of the chakra.
Well, not even a bigger hand, because how I see it used, it's more like it's almost like a mission card. You have to play it, you have to charge, and then you draw two. You know, it's loss, or, you know, one morning, or something, you know, something along those lines.
And I agree, but the thing with that is, I think Tsuchigomo should be kept at one, because your argument is to bump it to two, correct?
I think it deserves a little love, because, I mean, I don't really see many people use it.
Because it's at one.
Yeah, because it's at one. Nobody wants to use a card at one, usually. But it's hydro pump.
But imagine if you had that card, two of those in your hand, your jutsu face, right?
Yeah.
And you get this chakra back, you draw two cards, or in this case, you're drawing four cards because you're using it twice. When you draw those four cards, after that jutsu chain's over, who's to say, obviously we don't know because it's all game of chance, but you draw into a jutsu that would destroy the opponent's team.
Yeah.
You know, I think because it's such an aggro card and because it comes out so fast, that giving you that chakra and then allowing you to draw additional cards where you might draw into a jutsu to use on the next chain, I feel that's why it's at one. And I feel
why it's at one. But I don't know. I like the card.
It's a good card. It's like trying to make a case for Yamato CBF. Yeah. You know? It's like, oh well, he only negates everybody's effects. What's the big deal?
Comparative strengths. We don't know.
So besides that card, I think this one is for the Ambus, the turn ones and turn zero Ambus.
Yeah, turn one, turn zero Ambus.
So in case you don't know, these Ambus, there's two of them that allow you to put it into play.
Just regardless.
Yeah, regardless, for free, you know?
And then they have additional effects that support Ambus. And they're banned.
Banned completely.
You can play them all on you know, turn zero if you had them all.
Yeah, those cards are designed definitely for a rush aspect. When they were... when they weren't limited or banned, those cards saw play in every deck just because
you can get free cards.
It's one of those things.
Yeah.
But so what my brother's suggestion was, instead of banning the Ombus outright, giving them a friendly errata.
Yeah, I mean, there's a few other cards too that, you know, this could be done with, but a friendly errata, like effect can't be duplicated. You know, you only be able to, you know, put in one of those Ombus per turn, because you can't put them both, they have the same name.
So right.
You know. And I mean, there's other Ombus that you can use too. You can still make an Ombu deck, you can still make it good.
I have an Ombu deck,
but yeah, you can still make it okay. But I mean, the turn zero is a 0/2. I mean, even though it comes into play and gives Ombus +1/+1.
But if you chop three of them in one turn,
three of them in one
turn, and he gets them all +1/+1, yeah, it gets a little nutty.
You know, and then, you know, if you were to errata, you know, do a friendly errata to where it's, you know, once per turn or, you know, something like that, effect can't be duplicated.
Kind of like how what they did with Monkey King Emma.
Yeah,
instead of using
this
effect again and again and again, you could only use the effect once.
Right, because before I knew about that, I was Emma, and then my entire hand of Ninja Talks, you know?
Exactly.
So, I feel like, you know, we can get together with the people that we, you know, talk with and get a chance, not at a tournament because there's so much going on, but at another time to, you know, maybe go over some of the cards that are on the ban list and maybe possibly find a way to, you know, if some of them are just crazy like CBF,
yeah,
that's one thing.
That's one thing that'll never get off the
ban
list, so.
But something like that, you know, I don't run it myself. I was just thinking, you know, maybe something like that, because I can see why they're banned.
Yeah.
But then also, it's a very easy fix, especially because there's no other governing entity other than ourselves.
Yeah.
And our preferences.
Exactly.
So.
And, you know, and we don't just make decisions to make decisions. No, we try to be as democratic about it as possible. And, you know, everybody's opinions taken into account. And, like, these are just our opinions. And we try to bring these to light, so that going down the road, it gives some sort of format that people can follow. People can see that and say, you know what, these guys are taking the time, talking it out, trying to come up with ideas, and, you know, hopefully those ideas stick, because we're all about, you know, advancing the game in any way possible.
Yeah, well, cause, yes, especially since there's no other way to
advance
the game. So, I mean, we're not saying make your own cards or anything, which I'm pretty dang close to doing, but just more like just reviewing things a little bit closer with other people. Now that, you know, all these things are made during certain sets where this certain card was played a certain way and, you know, yada, yada, yada. But, I mean, you know, since set 5 or 6, you know, there's certain cards that you're probably never going to see play in the first place.
Yeah.
And then that also being said, there are cards from new ones that make old set cards ridiculous. So, you know, it's a kind of weeding through it all. The recent combo that was found by Jason Smith, again, another shout out, and another friend of his, was the 4x faster combo.
Yeah, that combo is nutty. There's a lot of steps to it, but to really sum it up for you, 4x faster, the mission card, basically what it says is, I think it's on, like, turn 2 or 3. Is it turn 2 or 3 mission?
I'm actually not sure.
So for all intents and purposes, say it's turn 2 or 3. What this does is it allows you to turn your marker up by 4.
By 4.
Turn your marker up by 4. And the combo was ridiculous. And what happened with the combo is you... What is it? Squat out Naruto?
No, you reinforce Naruto with the Hokage promo.
Yeah, right.
Which searches out for Minato Childhood. And then you squat Naruto Minato head, which gives a damage to your opponent's field.
And then you squat back out.
And then you reinforce back out.
Yeah, reinforce back out. And then squat back in. And then basically it destroys the entire field. You have 3 teams of 6.
Yeah.
And you just attack and basically win the game. And looking at that, when he showed me that combo, when we read it, it's ridiculous. 4x faster is a card you never really would have thought of. And I just think that's too fast for the game.
Yeah.
Just to completely destroying your opponent on turn 3, and they don't even have a fighting chance. Yeah. It takes away the fun from the game, and it takes away the competitiveness. And if you can just constantly do that, which the combo isn't hard to pull out.
Yeah, it's not hard.
It's not hard to pull out at all. Yeah, none of them are banned. And so that's one of those cards that a lot of people, I had put up a poll on Facebook about it, saying, you know, hey, take a look at this. This is how this is done. What do you guys think? You know, and trying to get a popular vote so that we could, you know, put it on the ban list. So that's still in process.
Yeah.
But besides that, there's another mission card called the Eight Inner Gates.
One of many, but the one that we're talking about.
Yeah, this particular one.
The same thing, except it goes up, what, by five?
By five.
Turn earlier, or something like that.
It's ridiculous.
And, you know, it gives the same thing.
So, you know, if you really take the time to look at these cards, there are cards that have very similar effects, different names, and, you know, again, thank you, Jason Smith. If you don't take the time to read these cards and look into the possibilities, I mean, not only one, does that make you, would lessen your experience as a player and, you know, it's preventing you from moving forward as a player. It takes away from the game. You know?
Yeah, a little bit. And, you know, for someone to find a combo like that and then not go and use it,
yeah,
that says a lot. That says, this is ridiculous. I see it as ridiculous and I've found it. Not everyone has access to those Kage and Arigatos. But Jason sure did.
Yeah.
And so that was very big of him. And thank God he wasn't able to use it against us. But, you know, to come out and say this is ridiculous and it should definitely be banned right now because of this exact reason was really cool. And then us finding Eight Inner Gates, you know, that does the same thing.
Ridiculous.
Yeah. So
it's pretty good. But with that, you know, cards being similar that aren't on the ban list, there are cards that are very similar that where one is and one isn't.
Yeah, exactly.
For instance, Exposing the Hideout. Exposing the Hideout is an Earth Wind Jutsu, costs 3 anything, 3 colorless, and it says, look at all of your opponent's battle wards, select one ninja among them, and put into the user's team in any position.
Yeah, no entrance costs.
Yeah, it does, no requirements. So you can imagine for like me, as a BR player, knowing what I'm putting in my battle wars area, it made it so much easier for me to get the first Akagi out or to get somebody out that I needed on turn one.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, and that card was busted. It was at 1 for the longest time, but, you know, rightfully so, it got put to 0, which I...
No, I...
Thumbs
I,
up to that.
Yeah.
Thumbs up to that, because that card's very, very good, and it can be used in any deck.
Yeah.
So even if you're taking a chance, you know, a shot in the dark, chances are you're probably going to find a ninja in there, and you're going to be able to put them in the team, give you that, you know, little bit of edge against your opponent. And so, yeah, that card's very justified into why it's put at 0. On the flip side, there is a mission card called Capturing the Missing Pet Tora. It's a turn 2,
0 hand cost.
0 hand cost. Like, so, again, can be played in any deck. And it does the same exact thing.
Well, you know, not during the exchange. You can't put it in your team.
Right.
But at the same time, you know, it goes into play.
Yeah, not during the exchange jutsu, but, you know, during your mission phase, you do whatever, play a ninja, you drop that mission, your opponent has 5 battle wards, chances are you're going to hit a ninja in there. And just, and like, maybe it's a ninja you need. Or maybe it's turn 3 and it's a turn 6 ninja that's going to completely change the landscape of the game.
Yeah, exactly.
Drop them into play, it's essentially the same as that card.
Easier to pull off, in my opinion.
Yeah, definitely, because you don't have to charge Shocker for it.
No, you just charge them. You just play the damn card.
You just play the card. You know, you don't have to worry about, oh, what am I gonna drop to play this card because I really need it. And that card is completely legal. It's not limited. It's not banned. It's at 3.
Yeah. And I don't think that particular one should be limited because the fact, or not limited, but banned completely because the fact that it is just put in play. There's a ton of other effects like that. But, you know, now that we're sharing this information gets out there, you know, having something like that limited to probably 1 because of its usefulness at the same time.
Yeah, absolutely. And, like, again, we're not trying to, like, say this is how it should be. We just notice these things and we want to make people aware of it, you know.
Yeah.
We feel it's part of our job as not only YouTubers of the game, but...
Players.
Just as players of the game, we want to give that information to you guys so you know what you can and cannot do, what different combos you might like and stuff like that. And we just try to bring the information to you guys. But again, you know, capturing this pet tour, definitely one of those cards you probably put at 1.
Yeah, Because, I mean, there's other cards like it, too, but a lot of those just bring them to your hand. You know,
yeah.
There's a Naruto, you know, take one of your opponent's battle wards, bring it to your hand. You know, Emergency
Call-Out, yeah.
You know, which is a card I like to use, just because, you know, you get a battle reward bag, but you also get to look to see, it's actually only Ninja, you know.
Yeah, you can see what's in there.
But sometimes you don't hit it. And I mean, it'll be the same thing with exposing and...
Well, even if you don't hit the card, it's good to know what you're not getting.
That too. And then even then, if I find a turn six, I still gotta wait till turn six to play it.
Right.
You know?
Right. But, yeah. I mean, there's so much more that we want to talk about, but for the sake of the video and making it very, very long, we don't want to wear you guys out. And we want to have that content that we can show you guys later down the road.
Yeah.
So, you know, with that, as always, I want to say thank you to everybody that's subscribed to the channel, everybody that's supported the channel. Hit that like button for additional content, guys. Also, there's a little bell up in the top right-hand corner. Hit that bell so every time I post a new video, you guys will get it automatically so you can see what we're rambling on about. Mm-hmm. And, you know, tell your friends about us. You know, if you have friends who really are trying to get into Naruto, people who want to learn the game, you know, we're happy to, you know, give assistance. You know, leave comments on the YouTube channel. You can direct me. You can, you know, directly message me if you'd like. Totally fine. You know, I'll answer any questions you guys have. And always, leave suggestions in the bottom. You know, anything you guys want to see, we're up to do. If you guys want to hear us talk about a card, you want to see gameplay footage, or, you know, talk about erratas of cards, whatever it is. It doesn't even have to be about the card game. It can just be about Naruto in general. Or if you have a bad day, let us know, because we've had plenty of those. You know, we're here for you guys. We're here for the community. And that's all I got to say.
Well, speaking of the community and stuff, I want to maybe get a chance to bring in some of the other guys that we've started playing with, get their views on some of these things also. You know, maybe talking to, you know, some people. Maybe looking into, you know, other stuff too.
Yeah.
Games. So that way, you know, as much as we love Naruto, it's, you know, not what we want, you know, TDG to be all about. So.
No, absolutely. You know, like it's a very good point. You know, this is a starting point for us. We talk about Naruto specifically right now because it's what we know.
Yeah.
You know, eventually I would, you know, definitely love to journey into different topics. And, you know, like I said, anything you guys want to talk about, you know, we will talk about it, and nothing is really off limits at all. You know, we're very open-minded people. You know, we don't discriminate, no matter who you are, what you believe in, and I think that, like I said, it's huge. It helps build the community.
Yeah.
So, I mean, with that, this has been Big Juan Robles and Zenosis signing off, and for those of you keeping the Naruto CCG dream alive, we salute you.
Oh, man. We'll cut that last bit. We'll cut that. Yeah.